Alright guys, Damon from Black Warriors. We're kind of beached here just off of a gravel bar here. And we got our new channel cat chummers. Now we're not chumming for channel cats today, well at least not right now. We found some nice little school of bream up and down this wall here, and we got this nice spot here, so I'm beached up and we're gonna kind of chum this area. And I'm gonna show you some best practices that I found with the channel cat chummers. First of all, let me just kind of, it floats, that's the first thing. That's good. Then it makes a nice scoop. And also, because the cup is not too big, you won't over chum. Okay. So what we're gonna do, I find that generally an underhanded sort of toss does pretty well. It gets out there okay. You can go overhanded. If you wanna go overhanded, don't throw it like that because it'll just deposit right here. You should come back here at about 4 o'clock and stop at about 2 o'clock. A little bit of chum. It'll get on out there. Some of it will drop right there, but for the most part, you'll get it on out there. You know, you want to go ahead and it's those little pieces way out there that you really want. Get right here. And throwing with the wind is best. You can do it overhanded or cross-chested like this if you want. That, you know, that's the, you know, you want to accelerate to a stop, you know, boom. I find that side-arming gives the most distance and the best dispersion pattern. So we're just kind of chumming this area up. That's plenty of chum. And guess what? Our bait's already in the chum, so that'll help bring them in. And what we'll do now is just... oh, come on. And that's how we do that. And as you can see, the fishing video that we had just earlier, I mean, it works. So let's see what we can do here. This nice little gravel bar. It's probably an inlet stream right back here behind us. And, keep talking about the battery life. I think I may have more video space than I have battery life. But we'll see, you know. We're gonna come right off this weed bed here. Nice long cast in like that, almost down to the spool. Time to re-spool this thing. And we're just sort of drop shotting this thing. Cool thing about the motor is the foot is kind of anchored, and it's kind of anchored the boat. Haven't actually had to tie off, which is kind of neat. But yep, there he goes. He's getting hit. You see that? You see that hits? You see those hits? But there's something right there, like a log or something. He's playing with it again. Most of the time they hook themselves. And he was, you saw I was just playing with it, right? Anyway, there we go there. You got one of them. That's why I always put two on. If I put just one on, they won't seem to bite it much. I don't know why. They just don't. And I just never see anybody fishing like this. I never see anybody drifting along the walls. I mean, because they're all bass fishermen, and they're just wanting to, you know, well, I guess I shouldn't talk bad about other people's fishing, but it's just not me. It's not for me. I mean, bass fishing ain't for me. Give me bream, give me catfish. You can catch as many of them as you want. I can actually eat them. I mean, you can eat bass, but I'd much rather have bream and catfish, really. But Yeah, somebody's at it already. Yeah, I tried to set the hook, didn't it? No. So, you see they're in here and they're biting. And so anyway, if you want one of these channel cat chummers, I got three of these. Well, I got some that I just shipped to the Amazon warehouse. So you can buy them there. I've got another shipment coming in. It's a China-made product, you know. It's meant for a whole other industry, but I figured it could be used for chumming. And so so I'm using it here. So I got another shipment coming in a few days, but I got three of these that I want to get out to some of you guys. Got three more at the house. I'm only using this one for myself until I get the other ones in. But if anybody wants to try it, just give me a ring. I've got three of them, so there's only three available to try. The rest of them are going to be going to the warehouses and things like that. I think that may have landed in the trees. Yeah, it did. Another little guy. There's a bait guy right there. River's on the rise. Sunfish that time. River's on the rise. We'll save this guy here for bait. Again, we just chummed up the area. He's gonna poop on me, seriously, dude. Oh gosh, yeah, river's definitely rising. Cool thing, the boat can float in such shallow water, right? It's kind of like having a kayak with a nice little, you know, 6-horsepower motor on it. But anyway, we're catching them. Stay tuned. Before you leave a spot, you always generally want to chum it up some more, just to kind of keep the, that was a bad throw. Side-arming it like that's the best way to go, really. Just, you know. Alright. That's that. We're gonna push another drift. Seriously? Oh. Keep forgetting to crank this sucker up with the safety key here, the whatever this thing's called. Kill switch. All right. Nice spot. That's a pattern. If we want to fish from the bank, we can kind of get on these sand gravel bars like that and cast out and fish. Probably could do decent on some jugs here too, but we're learning these waters and that's what's most important. All right, let's get back upstream. Not too bad, just off that log there. Current's not helping as much, wind isn't either at this point, but oh come on fella, why you have to swallow it? Beautiful sunfish, a lot of sunfish. I think that's why orange and yellows work so well in these waters, and as well as greens, you know, in terms of Oh gosh, I hate to hurt the fish like that, but again, he's probably gonna either be bait or we're gonna end up eating him, so that's okay, we can do that. And so we're kind of nestled here in these trees, and look at that, it's automatically downturned the eye. If I try to bend it back, it might break, but yeah, oh well. But anyway, we'll rig up and go again. All right, so let's chum up this area. We've already caught several mini fish here, but we're going to chum up the area here. And just a little bit of chum here and there. I'm not trying to get great distances off this chum here. Although, that's the way to do it if you want more distance and more area covered. Sidearm it. And then, and what we do is we'll just drop this and see that the dropper loop helps it move freely, so and see what we can do there. Okay, and let me stand up. Much easier to fish standing up than it is sitting down. Get pitch it in there a little bit better than I just did there. Oh, come on, seriously? Gotta be kidding me. Hate it when that happens, but it does. Professional overcast. There we go, right beside that thing. Huh. I can feel I'm getting hits. I can feel it in the line before I even hit it. Yeah. Yeah, well. Interesting. So all we do is throw out a little chum and we just drop our worms right down there off in the chum and they just go to hitting it. Bam, bam. Just you see how fast that was a hit? Let's see if we can cast it right back out there. We're going to keep pitching it there. We're kind of nestled in these weeds here. These weeds are just all throughout this lake and the waters around these parts. Before we even reel up, we'll be getting hits and stuff. And but anyway, and sometimes if I don't get hits immediately, I'll just go ahead and reel it back in and just, you don't have to wait a long time. Right there, that's where I want it. Huh, may have knocked off there. Sometimes you gotta jiggle it and work it a little, just like you would an artificial, but not all the time. Oh well. Dropper loop's probably a little bit too long. What's this rebait?
Luck on the jugs. All brim today.
I was gonna say no luck on these jugs, man. They were just all brim today. They just weren't biting, man. But I like these jugs. We're gonna continue trying. Figure if I can get about 60 of these running, run about 20 at a time. You know, if you run 20 in one spot, go to another spot, drop 20 more, go to another spot, drop 20 more, and then come back. That way you can work three spots all day long like that. but you know, we got to wait for the, either we need to wait for the other jugs to cure, or we need to go ahead and make them. And just go ahead and make them and get them up and running. But we got a lot of bream, and some of it with the chum, some of it without. And again, if you want one of these, check out the Amazon page. And if you want to try one, all I have is three to give out for samples for people to try. So if you want to try one, hit me up and I'll mail one out to you so you can try it. And if you want, go on over to the Amazon page and buy one. I only have a few at the Amazon warehouse right now, but again, I got another whole shipment coming in the coming days. I'll be keeping you guys apprised on that. And I will talk to you guys later, man. That's it for this trip. A lot of good bream. Found a nice pattern of bream. Drifting these walls here on the, along the weed beds. And we still got some, I would imagine there's some pretty decent catfishing along the same path that we were bream fishing on. Actually, I think that's the next thing to try. I guess the thing with jugs is you get a bunch of them. Get a bunch of them, a bunch of them, a bunch of them. Get 40, 50, 60, 80, 100 of them. And just, you know, work them. And, but anyway, that's it. Damon Black Warrior Lures. Check out these channel cat chummers. They're good for carp, bream, bluegill, anything, any kind of fish where you're going to chum, man. It's good to have it. A scoop and a throwing device all in one. See you guys later.